Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can print these two patterns in C programming. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through this link, that is youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my Android app, that is TechMS, based on programming, which is available on Google Play. Now coming on to the topic. First, you have to understand how this pattern can be printed on console. So for this purpose, you can study this analysis. Here I have replaced space with hyphen and then digits are available. So if you want to print first row, then a loop will be required, which will display spaces four times first and then one digit will be displayed. Now, if we talk about second row, then three spaces. So space loop will repeat three times now and digits loop will repeat two times now. So this way a loop will be required which will be printing spaces, and then second loop will be required which will print required number of digits on console. Now to control these two loops, one more loop will be required which will represent which number of row we are printing. So for this purpose, I have already implemented this code for you. Here you can see I loop, which will control row number, second loop which will display spaces, and third loop which will print digits. So now let's take an example. Suppose value of n is 5, which is received through this scanf, because printf is printing enter how many rows you want to print. So n is 5, so this loop will start from 1. Here condition is true. Now you can see second loop, its condition is n minus I. So n is 5, I is 1. So this loop will repeat 4 times. J loop is repeating 4 times. So 4 spaces will be displayed. After termination of J loop, control will be transferred to K loop. So J loop is repeating 4 times, but K loop will repeat 1 time because its condition is K less than equals to I and I is 1. So 1 time it will print K. So K is 1. So 1 will be displayed on console. So you can see our requirement. If we talk about first row, space loop will repeat 4 times and digit loop will repeat 1 time. So here you can see space loop is repeating 4 times and digits loop is repeating only 1 time. Then new line, then I plus plus, I will be 2. This time n minus I, 5 minus 2. So this time space loop will repeat 3 times. And K loop will repeat 2 times because I is 2. You can see in second row, requirement is space loop should repeat 3 times and digit loop should repeat 2 times, and that is happening. So this way, if I execute this code, I will receive first pattern. You can see it here. I am receiving first pattern displayed on console. Now I want to print this pattern in reverse order. So for this purpose, I have to change first loop, that is representing I. So here initialization is I equals to n. Condition will be I greater than equals to 1. And in place of I plus plus, I have used I minus minus. By changing only this first loop, the reverse of the pattern will be displayed on console. You can see it here. Reverse is displayed as it is required in this pattern. Both are same. So with this way, through this code, I have printed reverse pattern. Now you can see I is starting from 5. So first time J loop will repeat 0 times because n is 5 and I is also 5. So 5 minus 5 is 0. So no space will display on console, and K loop will repeat 5 times because I is 5. So it will display 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which are values of K. Each time K loop will be repeating. So starting from 1 to 5, all the digits will be displayed in single row. Then new line, then I minus minus. So I will become 4. So next time 5 minus 4. So one space will be displayed and K loop will repeat 4 times. So this way reverse of the pattern is displayed on console. So I hope you have understood how you can print both the patterns on console using nested loops in C programming. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow this link, that is youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. Thank you for watching this video.